Good afternoon and a warm welcome to the LaSalle International Circuit. Welcome to Doha. MotoGP 2024 then is officially go.
Jorge Martin, last year's sprint winner, who comes towards the finish line, which is coming over now, and Martin does replace his fellow Spaniard at the top. Jorge Martin, quickest then on a 152.624.
You feel like it's almost written in the stars.
Believe the hype.
The rookie goes to the top of the timesheet. This is him pushing, full attack, dangles that right leg. And this is going to be a scare for Acosta in that first corner. He tips at RC16, throws it in on its side. What a save already. Look at that big dark line. That Michelin rear tyre leaves pretty much all the way throughout the whole of that first corner of the show. Welcome to MotoGP. This is him now,
six.
Super sideways, going into turn six. He's pretty much crammed a season's worth of entertainment into 45 minutes.
One of his brake protectors has gone off with it, so he's left a trail of destruction too.
He just jumped on the bike and he does it like almost natural. And as you know, we receive many top Moto2, world Moto2 world champion. Respect for all of them because they're all great riders. But I have to say that if you ask me the question, it's special, it's different, it's better.
El Capitano, he says this without any question is the best Aprilia he has ever ridden. He feels in the best shape of his life. At the start of the year, he was on a Canary Island training camp with his great friend Jorge Martin. Instantly fell head over heels in love with the new Aprilia in Valencia. And he feels like, this is a big statement from LA, he feels like Aprilia have taken a bigger step than any other factory in the close season. Aleix Espargaró making good on his promise to potentially score a first ever Aprilia podium here at the LaSalle International Circuit. He was second. Mark Marquez, he threatened this a couple of laps ago before he ran wide. He has now indeed gone top of this rain-affected session. Given his lack of experience on the Ducati in rain conditions, Mark's actually topped that session with a 206.544. Brad Binder's also been on a strict diet throughout the winter. I don't think it was anything to do with getting in his suit for his wedding back in early December. But Brad Binder, the diet worked a treat because at the moment he's just gone to the top of the timesheet. It's our first sub 153 lap so far here this weekend in Qatar. Binder down to a 152.889. Okay, so we've got Jack Miller first, Pedro Acosta second, Augusto Fernandez fourth. Okay, it is wet, but it's a good chance while they're having such a good session to talk about KTM and GasGas. Of course, it's the same bike, just running under different banners. You've always been keeping an incredibly close eye on KTM's progress. You've been keeping a close eye throughout winter testing. We've talked about the riders. Have KTM put a bike underneath them this year that's good enough to fight for the championship?
Just about Pekka Davide in that interview with Jack down in pit lane earlier in the session said that he's not feeling good with the front end. Remember this morning I noticed that they're running the front end in two different positions. And they had a different exhaust, you know, the old one and the new one. They've settled on the new exhaust. But going into the session, I looked at his bike and it still has the two bikes, his two bikes in different headstock positions. So he still hasn't found it, you know, but, you know, the sweet feeling front end-wise.
What's that? You want more? Click here to subscribe.